Hey, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of two versions of architectural blueprint drawings from photos. I provided a Photoshop template that you could download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. It includes two images, graph paper and paper texture. When you click the link, you may see only one of the images in the preview window. However, once you open it in Photoshop, you'll see the two layers. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to place the photo into the template. Make sure your Move tool is active and drag it onto the tab of the template. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold the Shift key as you drag it down and release. Pressing Shift kept your photo centered. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner. On version CC 2019 and later, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it in or out until it fills the document. On earlier versions, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it. Then press Enter or Return or click the check mark at the top. I'll cancel it since I already sized it earlier. Drag the photo below the other two layers and hide those layers. We'll convert our photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right corner and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Find Edges. Next, we'll apply Level and Vertical Perspective Corrections. Go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. On earlier versions, this window will look different, which I'll show you in a moment. Open Geometry. The upright filter is what we'll be using. Click the vertical icon, which makes the vertical lines in our image straight up and down. On earlier versions, the camera raw filter will look more like this. Notice the top row of icons. Click this one, which is the lens correction filter. In the manual tab, you'll see upright. Click the vertical perspective icon. Next, we'll add a thin outline frame surrounding our blueprint image. Double-click an empty area of the photo's layer to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow. If the color box isn't black, click it, and when the color picker opens, pick black. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the noise is 0. The technique is irrelevant since the choke is 100%. The source is edge, and the size is 51 pixels. The contour is linear, and the range is 50%. Click Stroke. The color is white, the size is 60 pixels, and the position is inside. The blend mode is normal, and the opacity is 100%. Presently, we won't see the thin outline until we convert our image into a smart object. Click the adjustment layer icon and click black and white. Make the paper texture visible and active. Change its blend mode to linear burn. Make the graph paper visible and active and change its blend mode to linear burn as well. Reduce its opacity to 70%. Click the adjustment layer icon and click solid color. In the hexadecimal field, type in 0036A5. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Change the blend mode to screen. Next, we'll add text to our blueprint. Make the photo active and make a new layer above it. Open your horizontal type tool and make sure black is your foreground color. If it isn't, press D on your keyboard. open the blueprint font I provided the link to. I'll make the size 20 points, the aliasing sharp, and the alignment flush left. Determine which inside corner you'd like to place your text. If the corner is empty, we can just go to that corner and type out our text. To adjust the space between the lines, known as leading, double-click the large T of your text layer to highlight your lines of text, and go to Window and Character. In the Character panel, hover your cursor over the leading icon and drag the scrubby slider to the right or left to increase or decrease the leading. To reposition it, place your cursor to the right of your text and drag it into position. Then open back your Move tool. If you want to replace your text over an area that isn't empty, no problem. Drag it to that area. We'll create a new layer below our text by Control or Command clicking the New Layer icon. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag it over your text to the outline border. We'll fill the selection with white, and since our background color is white, press Control or Command plus Delete. Then deselect it by pressing Control or Command D. Next, we'll add a thin outline border to the rectangular shape that surrounds our text. Double-click the rectangular shape layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke and the color box. Pick Black. The stroke appears blue because we have a solid blue color adjustment layer at the top of our layers panel, which is affecting all the layers below it. Make its size 3 pixels. If the rectangular outline isn't flush with the edge of your blueprint, no worries. Just press the up, down, left, or right arrow on your keyboard to move the outline 1 pixel at a time in the direction you want it to move. Let's close the character panel since we're not going to use it anymore. To invert the colors of our blueprint, scroll to the top of the layers panel and make the graph paper active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Invert. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.